Be jumping right into that. Not too much of a change-up either in the draft, but some new heroes coming out.
Yeah, it seems like OG is still going for the Wisp. Don't want to give up on the Wisp. I'm not sure why they picked Venge. I mean, Beast Venge is like the classic aura combo. Kill everything, kill all
that
towers.
Physical damage.
Yeah. It's kind of stops OG from picking Husker if they really want to. I mean, Husker does care and doesn't care. They do have like the pure physical damage against them, but I don't think OG is looking at Husker anyway. I can see them maybe even pick Faceless Void if they feel it.
Yeah, that's what they've been doing mostly. Maybe, I mean, Grand Finals usually tends to have their own meta when these two teams start to like know each other a lot more. So definitely some change-ups going to be happening, but the Void is the one that definitely does stand out.
OG's thinking, like you said, it's a new meta game now between two teams in the Grand Finals. So
yeah, I actually have no idea what they're going to pick right now. It's like they have a Wisp.
I mean, they're Dire, so since they're Dire, they probably don't want Invoker.
What about Legion Commander?
Read more Legion, guys.
It's kind of cool against Beast. All right.
Here we go. Shit.
It's like, why not?
Yeah, just big change up there.
Single fucks given.
Yeah. It's actually...
also, it's like, just give me Storm.
Yeah.
Right. OG's played Dire all three games.
Yeah.
Was it, right?
They do prefer Dire. So they give up anything for Dire. At the same time, Winx Gaming actually chooses second pick sometimes.
Yeah.
So, yeah. You have that kind of game.
From a Moon Meander. Humping with his chair.
It's very cool to look at.
Miracle's nice tattoo and everything on his arm.
So cool, actually.
So, yeah, mid one, as a Storm expert, what do you think about this hero? I saw your Storm earlier this tournament with one Bloodstone charge, so I'm wondering.
I thought I was the Storm expert here. I was playing against Winx Beastmaster as well.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
Yeah. So how are you, Matu?
Yeah, two Storm experts.
Yeah, you had a Storm expert, you play against Beastmaster.
I mean, honestly, I just like buy mana boots into Bloodstone into Lincoln.
Yeah, Lincoln seems kind of cool here.
Yeah.
But hard to get. Like, it's a lot of items. Bloodstone Lincoln game might already be pretty hard at this point.
I could actually see this Silencer come back.
Silencer?
Yeah.
For Winx?
Yeah. Against Aya Storm Spirit.
I mean, it's like you look at these like blue heroes of OG, they just look weakish. Like they look like paper.
That is true.
So Winx might just YOLO it up.
When do they not, right?
That's true. It's like the Ricky ban is a very normal ban, especially because Winx is very good with this hero.
Yeah, they are good at bounty too.
Yeah, they're good with the Invis. I'm not sure about the Sven ban. I guess with Sven is like casually good. At the same time, Warcry like seems good against Beast and Venge. I think usually it doesn't really matter, but I think Winx don't really know what to ban just because they open up with Storm. It's hard to get into the minds of OG at this point, what they're going to be about.
Yeah, very different from pretty much every other opener that we've been seeing in this tournament.
Yeah.
Just want to see if Light caught up in the game, giving some mana for his boys.
In the second banning phase, you just need to look out for the healers and Husker a lot, if you like keep them in mind. Maybe OG might just ban Husker, because they don't want to deal with him anymore. It's just like Dazzle Husker in the pool.
Do you think the mid one, actually, I'll ask you that. Do you think that Winx are looking at Keeper of the Light here, since they did really like it versus Storm Spirit, at least in the game that you were the Storm?
I think it's pretty hard for Storm, actually, this game. But I'm not sure. If I was the Storm, what? How would I play, actually?
I think OG might want to get Coddle themselves.
Mm-hmm. I was talking about OG Coddle.
Yeah, I just meant, like, Winx it also like played it, so maybe just in case OG didn't take it, if it would work out for Winx.
I mean, both teams keep the call in mind when they draft, always. I feel like there will be a call in this game.
You can feel it?
Yeah, I feel it.
On both sides?
Yeah, I think either one can just go for the call. Unless Winx is gonna like Husker it. They have the opening for it. Storm is naturally good against these passive heroes like Dazzle, because he just jumps them and kills them. But at the same time, they have Beastmaster and Vengeful Spirit. It's a very strong backup. I don't know, I wouldn't feel comfortable playing Storm right now.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, he probably has a lot of confidence just picking first two Storm.
Like yeah. I think, like, both teams are trying to, like, feel each other up, or like what to do. It seems very, like, self-centered, what they want to play.
The five-man ball is coming.
Yep. Five-man.
Yeah, DK is, like, a classic favorite pick against Storm. It's a very simple concept of... You have a 3-second stun against Storm, an instant stun that latches him. You've seen a lot of DK versus Storm in TI5. Then Storm got nerfed, so we rarely see this matchup nowadays.
Yeah,
this is the first time Storm came back for 1 year now.
Yeah, and with the like the breathe fire change that happened quite a while back, reducing damage when you get hit by it, and then also raindrops being added helps DK quite a lot versus Storm Spirit.
Yeah.
Tree. It works good against all the physical damage on wings. But I just, I fear for OG, they need some guy who just like deals all the damage in their team. Like Storm is just gonna kill one guy, but then there's like four other guys to kill.
Yeah, right now I would definitely favor Wings Gaming Draft. It just looks more obvious what they're about, while OG Zeros, they're just kind of mysterious, weak.
I think OG heard us. Now they're gonna play the Orb of Venom, this trend.
Oh yeah.
Just chase them down with Wisp.
It's time to smack some people.
So to start to smack them.
And Trin got like a 6 damage buff on base damage. I mean, I don't know why they picked Trin Protector.
I think OG needs someone to stand in front, so that Storm can kill the supports.
Rubik is favorite pick against Trin. If you have a Rubik player and Wings Gaming is a Rubik team, like playing Rubik against Trin is very comfortable. You get a lot of good spells. If you get living armor once, you're just a better Trin protector for your game, for your team.
And like you were mentioning, the like death ball kind of lineup, more auras. Rubik has no field as well on top of everything else, on top of the Vengeance Beastmaster aura.
Yeah, OG needs like a ultra hero that wins the game for them. I'm not sure if Storm is enough. They do have like one more core to pick.
Yeah, they still lack damage really in their lineup. Like the Storm can get into the backline, like Matu was saying, but killing off the rest of the heroes, and there's not really any big like synergy with the Chronosphere, you could say right now.
Yeah, actually both teams have it in common. They need a real carry in the game. Mm-hmm. Like even though Wings Gaming's lineup looks well rounded, they also lack something. They lack the like to seal the deal kind of hero.
Troll Warlord, man.
That is actually smart. I feel like Troll would have worked really well in this lineup. Faces Foot enjoys it, Storms enjoys it.
Yeah, Trin Protector. Trin
enjoys it.
Yeah, Trin, definitely.
Yeah, Trin.
That backswing.
Yeah. Oh boy. I'm feeling it. Too bad.
Too bad.
Too.
I mean, this is the most conservative lineup of Wings we've seen maybe so far. It's just very well rounded. Two supports, Venge Rubik, DK mid, Beast offlane. Well, OG is going full crazy here. They have the double hold down, Trin the ulti, Chronosphere.
Zero stuns.
Yeah, no stuns.
No stuns.
And they
seems like they want to face rush them.
That's the damage.
Tree gyro. Yeah. We used to see that a while ago.
I think they might aggro with Tree Gyro and put the Void safe lane. I think that's a possibility for OG. If they see the last hero Wings, they will consider contesting them.
Yeah, Venge Rubik are not really the most ideal two supports to just be standing face to face with versus an aggro tri lane.
Yeah.
So and they even go for it. That's pretty much like they're gonna go aggro for sure.
I believe so.
Yeah. Anti-mage.
Anti-mage is like pretty much seal the deal hero. While I don't really feel the Gyrocopter as that kind of hero. This is a very free anti-mage game. If anti-mage is gonna get like his timings on the Battle Fury, in a normal time period, like to say to 15 minutes, while OG is just having normal net worth, the game can just fall apart quickly for OG because they can't deal with any mage. They have a Chronosphere, I guess Tree and ulti, but not really because they get Manta style. Gyrocopter can't be face to face against any mage. Storm, I think everyone who plays Dota knows about the any mage Storm relationship. You can just blow up as Storm.
This game feels so weird. It feels like there's so much greed in both lineups.
This what?
There's so much greed.
Oh, greed. I wouldn't say Winx Gaming's lineup is greedy. I guess because of the two supports and the animage, but I don't know.
Beastmaster
doesn't look like they're gonna start aggro. Maybe they'll make a move with the Void instead of with the Gyro, but
yeah, I would favor the Radiant lineup here for sure if I would have to play this game, because their game plan is very natural. It's like Beastmaster is gonna like deal with the top lane at some point with the Hawks, and the OG lineup has a hard time dealing with it. And the Animage just needs to farm up, and the OG is the team that has to set all the tempo and apply tons of pressure to be in the game, because if the game stagnates and it's a 50-50 game, the Winx Gaming heroes will just naturally overpower OG's lineup.
Yeah, and it's like a lot is on Moon's shoulders if it gets to that point for him to just land like really perfect Chronospheres.
Yeah.
Because yeah, like we were mentioning, they don't really have any lockdown.
Yeah, OG gotta come big with this Trent IO doing work in the early game if they wanna win this game.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, let's see what the Storm Spread is about. Maybe he's gonna do some crazy moves.
Yeah, maybe they have like the Wisp Storm Spirit. We used to see that a bit. The Wisp just obviously stacks up and then makes the rotations after the Storm pushes the wave in.
That might be a very good reason why OG's opting for a safe lane. So the Wisp has the freedom to just stack the neutral camps.
Can also, I mean, you can kind of punish the DK too. Like DK versus Storm, not really the most ideal for the DK. And then if you have a crit, or if you have a Wisp there as well, maybe be a bit more annoying. But
well, DK actually doesn't really care. He does enjoy like holding two heroes like that, because his passive is just very good to just chill there.
Yeah.
Rubick is helping him, so I think DK is fine.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah, if anything, the only interesting, the real interesting part is that the Beastmaster is choosing to lane, but I think he should go to jungle. He actually does have an Iron Tail.
Yeah.
So he does that kind of jungle. It works. It's less efficient as starting out right away in your own jungle and just like speed up the process. You can get like what, 6 levels in 430 if you have the right camps and become a real pain in the game. But I guess he wanted to test the waters and see how he can handle the top lane, but tree and protector. What a hero. Hits you twice, you don't want to stay there anymore.
Yeah. You're just like, whoops, never mind.
So it's very common of a Moon Meander to just contest his lane. He always goes there and just tries to hold the guys there. The Wisp also spot him now. Just put the pressure. You want to pressure any mage. You never want to give any mage a free game unless you know you have the correct matching cores. I'm not sure if OG feels this way. They might, because they have the Chronosphere, tree and ulti. But at the same time, you still want to slow down his any mage farm as much as possible.
Oh, DD Turin.
Oh, oh god. 200 damage per hit.
Please, do it.
You might just save
just
it for Miracle,
it.
Right? Just take it, because we want to see it.
It's a very good move by Fly to stop the Beastmaster from flying.
Oh,
he's dead. Actually gonna die here.
Yeah.
It's a very good lane of Winx Gaming to deal with the Faceless Void, because it just burns his mana. We've seen a common theme of like Portals being there to mana leak the Void consistently. Any mage does the same. Just burns his mana so he actually cannot jump and he might just die. And Venge Rubick is just extremely strong support combo to deal with a single or even two heroes. And it's like the weakness of the Beastmaster if he just starts there. If you like, the Trin has an easy time just handling him as of now. I still think he should just go to base and heal up and go to the jungle.
Not now, first move being made by Winx. You get Miracle stunned up, disabled. Tree Armor comes out, but just not enough. Too much disable from the side of Winx.
Yeah, Winx is clever about dealing with these ganks because of Living Armor, so they don't go for these hide missions. They just bring at least 3 heroes to kill one target. Living Armor just doesn't do anything.
I like the speed at which they made the rotation too. It was like no hesitation after they get the Void kill. They basically move to the side, smoke up, and make the move to the mid.
Yeah, Winx Gaming is like a very timing-based team. Mm-hmm. They're very good at utilizing these timings. Like they freed up the bottom lane, so they're free to rotate. They have like 5 seconds to decide to move, and they just instantly went mid lane. Seize the chance, kill the Storm Spirit. Furthermore, it was between the rune spawns, so it's more unexpected than on the clear rune spawns. Mm-hmm. So it was a very natural good gank for them.
Just some nice casual farming back and forth. Lane's looking pretty even right now. Wings, of course, leading just a little bit because of the movements, but CS across the board is quite even. And Void, like we were mentioning, is... he's just forcing, at least like forcing some pressure into that offlane while the Beastmaster just was jungling, but now we do see Wings actually take the same approach. Nice.
Oh, there we see the worst train combo.
Oh, punch you, man. Do it.
He's good, man. Honestly, I just wanted a like great 10 seconds chase, like when the train just smacks him down.
Oh, they want to kill the Gyro. He's gonna survive with living armor, though.
I think Gyro is dead.
He's got axes as well. He should go down.
Oh, yeah. That was close.
That was very close.
Oh, yeah.
That was a really good rotation, by the way. It's like, they just don't care. Level 4 Beastmaster, let's gank the safe lane Gyro with the Lynch.
And the gank was good, but I think the Gyro could just run away.
Yeah. He could've.
Not sure. Like, he got the, well, as soon as he got the living armor, like, he looked like he could've ran, but he kinda turned.
I mean, I mentioned before, if they want the clear-cut kill, you need 3 heroes against the living armor.
Yeah.
But it would've still been a good rotation no matter what. Just to put pressure on the Gyro. Oh, he might kill him.
Crit. There's no living armor. He's gonna go down. So drag DK ult form, actually the poison working really well there versus the tree armor. And
there's some overextending by OG. I mean, to be fair, they just played us, so they're tired.
No problem, Wings. No problem.
But no. To be fair, like for real, if you play like a best of 3 and then you gotta play a best of 5, like we've been there now a couple times, it's very rough. Like it's a very rough experience. It's like a, I mean, like you guys know, like playing Dota is very exhausting, like very mentally exhausting. You know, you just gotta keep playing against different teams. You have no time to actually like prep up. On the other side, like I don't think they can prep up against Wings anyway.
Yeah, it's like how much does that really help you versus these guys?
Yeah, this game is Wings is being very comfortable for sure. Everything's working out for them. They got kills on every single lane. They killed every single core at least once. Killed some Wisp.
Yeah, and we'd mentioned that OG ideally in this laning phase want to come out ahead.
Yeah, their lineup is definitely snowball oriented more than anything else. Yeah, so now for Wings, all they have to do is pretty much hold the pressure they have. They don't need to do anything overly crazy. But you see, OG is setting up mid lane. They feel like they need to do something, and clearly so. They're right. They need to like put an action on some lane.
I think they should throw the Gyro to this moves and just like run
them. Yeah, I think he will TP in. Like I'm pretty sure he's ready to TP in because Wings Gaming will also retaliate. Then you have like the double retaliation of just everyone moving in minus the animage. But then, you know, they have like a Wisp tree and they're like, how do we kill this DK, guys? Like, he has like a big armor.
Can't smack him.
Oh, can't smack him. He's like this armor. It's like it hurts to hit him.
Yeah, we mentioned during the draft that they lacked some damage, so they like really need to be bringing the Gyro in for those rotations, especially in the early game.
Man, I wish I would be playing Animage this game.
This is the dream Anti-Mage game for sure.
Yeah. I know I had an anti-mage game like this.
one disable on the other team. No, no
like
worries.
No
in the
one
world.
Does anything to you. You're just free farming.
Yeah. Yeah. Look at the theme of this series. Like Wings is always making the first move. Now they're moving, and though like OG has the Gyro, and they actually need to do something to win the game.
Yeah. Yeah.
While Wings can just sit around and win the game by itself.
Yeah, they're coming.
Took all the creeps too, I think.
Oh,
and the raw.
That's Sator.
Get him, boys.
Helping him out.
Or slow, easy. That's how you smack people.
Dude, this is clear pattern of Wings just invading this this spot of Dire. Like 2 games in a row now, and in both games OG has been not prepared.
Arcane Rune DK as well. Now he can have a second DK.
He's manning up.
Can you be prepared for Phase Beyond? The famous offlaner of Wings Gaming. You can't.
He makes. He actually makes so many moves without vision.
DK is gonna die here.
Oh, uphill!
Oh, what? Oh. Yo, play beyond.
Yeah, it was very good for OG. That was a very correct response to save their mid tower. I think Wings just overextended there. They had no, like, no purpose to be there, because they used the raw cooldown.
Yeah.
And like OG didn't use a single cooldown. They saw the cooldown, and more importantly, the chronosphere. But sometimes you get into the zone and you just want to like keep going.
Yeah, it just seemed like he got very excited and got a little bit over aggressive.
Yeah, that's like definitely some Arcane Rune DK starting to shout. Like, I got this, guys, just come here. He's like, no,
guys,
man.
I'm really strong.
Yeah,
let's
I can tell you, in these things, like, at least one person is like deep in his heart. He's like, no, man, let's just back off. Like, let's not do it. But it doesn't matter.
It's tough. We need better free of anti-mish, I guess.
It kind of sucks, though, having your first DK ult being used like that, even though we like he had the Arcane Rune, so it's back up. Yeah. All the damage he pretty much did to the tower gets negated because of Treant.
I think they'll just straight up pressure mid again.
Yeah.
Treant.
Fly roared up. Getting lifted up Rubick's rotation, and Fly should be going down here.
Ult out.
The Wisp, Ice, dead for sure. Fifth beyond. No TP.
Oh,
Earth with a long jump.
Oh, yes, we can.
Very good response by OG. They just overwhelm them with more heroes. They don't lose the mid tower, but it would die inevitably. It was still better for OG, for sure.
Yeah.
The only problem is still this Animage. Like, he hasn't participated in this game so far. He's just doing his thing. It's very good by OG. They actually moved the gyro there to start pressuring him. But at this point, Animage can just safely jungle. Oh, the orange guy is very far up. I just warren tip it out. That's very sneaky.
They didn't see him at all, huh?
No, I'm not even sure how he got there. Like, I haven't paid attention. He just moved there.
Yeah, that's the innocence. He's the agent of
this guy is. Yeah, he really is. Like, he's every like single game.
He's just going deep into the enemy lines with his invis heroes.
Yeah, he plays his Venge like a Ricky.
Yeah, it's roleplay.
There was a game when Moon, I think Moon was playing Batrider, and he's Lion, like level 1. He's just like, I'm just going to run into the enemy jungle. And he like kills him, steals his stack. Like, this guy just, he has no fear, really.
Oh.
Relocate.
That's a really nice kill, but just before the micro.
Yeah. OG's picking up all the pieces
this
right now.
This needs to happen all the time, actually.
Yeah.
You need to get the kills on the core heroes before they like get their items, because they lose so much gold out of
making those first moves whenever they have an opportunity.
Yeah.
And then they've enforced the roar, so now there's even more of a bit of a window for OG.
They should go every minute, like, to be honest. Every single minute they should try to find a good kill on them. They also have trained ulti now.
Yeah.
And on the Winx side, you can say like Beast, you know, he doesn't have to be top. Like, Winx is very keen on putting map pressure, so they make space for the enemy mage. The Beast doesn't farm jungle solely because he's like, you know what, Shadow, like, you know, I'm gonna do it, you just keep farming and
I'm
stuff.
I'm your bro.
Yeah, I'm your bro in this game. Like, I'm gonna put pressure on the map. But obviously he doesn't wanna die, but OG is very quick and very smart finding the kill on him. It seems like Winx is a little bit lost right now, because they lost a lot of heroes. DK will make top rotation, push the tower with the Beast together. It's more solid, like if they're together they just won't die for no reason. They might make trade kills or even win the fight. Depends how like the spellcasting will go. I think there will be just like a mirror, like OG will just mirror. I think both teams are reading what's going on. You just accept it. If your safe lane tower is supposed to die, it's gonna die. It's hardest tower to defend on average in the game, tier 1 safe lane, because of the like whole territory. It's easy for the opponent to set the pace on the fights. Mm-hmm. I'm wondering if they're baiting right now.
Even bring the it looks like they are. They show the anti mage, but they didn't really show the other heroes.
I'm pretty sure OG knows what the case is. Oh,
it looks like Winx is like hesitating this push because OG is not really showing.
Yeah. Seem to be afraid. They don't want to lose more hero than that. They know if they like if they die one more time, Winx gaming, then the game might go out of hand because they already like fed them a lot of kills. Oh, it's a classic trade. Oh, OG wants to respond.
Yeah.
This could be pretty bad for Winx here. Depends on who really gets the jump in this situation.
It all comes down to this.
Dun, dun.
Get ready.
Putting my coins on Winx Gaming in this fight. Let's see.
Bet your coins on Winx?
Yeah.
Don't get coins.
All my coins.
I put my shekels on Winx.
Yeah, they have the Wisp Gyro position bottom for the
They're saving the tower right now. OG is just doing it.
Yeah.
At least.
Come on, guys. Just go for it. Yeah, boy.
A the river pits.
Yeah,
oh, oh, they actually got the first. Three man call down. There is an overgrowth from the Rubik. Blink in the front line with his armlet. Gets swapped out. Nice swap by Innocence. Not really enough damage coming out from either side right now, and they actually do get the relocate back, so now OG has to back out and lose this tower. Looks like your coins will be returned to you, Kuro. Good job.
Yeah.
Doubled up.
I mean, this feels just way too easy for Wings. Even though, like, they could have died there for sure. Like, the DK, I mean, he had the armor toggle and stuff. But it's just a very hard mission for OG to defend that kind of tower. When Wings is so prepared, the Animage was there too. That's five heroes, and OG is not there at once, so they need to relocate and do like all the jazz. And they can just burst one target with the Rubik Lift Roar. Go for it.
Wonder what Gyro is gonna build.
Yeah.
Like, if he wants to go greedy and try to match the Animage, or just like go for it.
I think Sentient Yasha for sure. It's even though the active is not good on ranged heroes, the stats are like very, very good for a hero like Gyrocopter.
Yeah. He just wants to move around the map so he can like surprise Wings off guard so they get these kills in.
Yeah, it's just stay fogged on the Gyro.
I will buy Rikyo Gyro right now.
First item.
Yeah, Rikyo and BKB, let's go.
No fear?
No fear, I have IO, man. Like, they need more damage.
So they need a Rapier.
Yeah, they need a Rapier.
Go for it later, if the game drags on.
Yep.
Yeah, just go for BKB and Rapier, man.
Pretty sure it's gonna be Sanjin Yosh. I mean, Rapier is... might work.
It's not the way.
Yeah, I feel like... I think both teams are like kind of happy. I think there's more pressure on Wings right now, because like suddenly the Storm and Gyro, they just picked up their net worth, like their farming speed. I'm wondering if Wings decides to search actively for a fight. Maybe they're waiting for something. If you look at the items, you just got Necro 1 on Beast. It's a pretty late Necro 1.
It's really weird to me. They're not going the typical Bankai mode on Wings side. It's like 10 to 20 minutes, but they're not like going for it.
I think it's like the Faceless Void and the Trin Protector. There's like a weird kind of psychological pressure, like the double ulti.
Yeah.
If they die once to it, they might just lose the game. Just cause the OG is dire, always chooses dire, takes the Roche. At the same time, there's the other point is that they know that Anti-Mage, he can carry this game. He just needs to pick up his items to make it safe. Anti-Mage is not a hero, it is common from what we've seen from Wings. They do play him from time to time, but there's a clear shift of gameplay from the side of Wings. Even Ancients are ganking them right now. So it's like, if you have Anti-Mage, you always make the choice, should we like play aggressive, or should we just like, you know, be Anti-Mage?
But do you like seeing methodical Wings, or run at you crazy Wings better?
I mean...
I like Bankai Wings.
I like both. I think they look uncomfortable. Like, just looking at them, how they position the heroes, it's clear Wings wants to go in. They want to, like, man mode. This is not Wings. They're trying to be someone they aren't. And clearly, like, they seem lost on the map. While OG is like more calculated. OG is like more ready. Like, they're consistently doing their things correctly. The Storm is farming all the time. Gyro is farming the Ancient's net worth, which is like a huge income. The supports are just being the supports. The two very defensive supports, Trin and Wisp.
Maybe that could be their time to go for Wings. The Blink Dagger on DK. They have a quick form of initiation now.
Yeah, at the same time, the Storm just picked up Bloodstone, and the other guy, the Gyro, Sentient Yasha. So we're gonna see like a real clash with all the items picked up.
Yeah, I didn't know.
Oh, he broke one of the broke the smoke with that.
Extremely good by Fly.
They have the sentry down. They're gonna find him. Yeah.
That was very good by Fly, and just very good response by Wings. Very quick to find him. Fly should have probably moved out after spotting the first smoke. But he was just one among the trees. Maybe I couldn't see him.
One among the trees.
at least now Wings gets maybe an opportunity to get that tier 1 bottom with the DK used. However, Fly's only dead for like 15 seconds.
Yeah, Wings want to push this tower, and then they like secure the Roshan area. Yeah. So OG doesn't have that big of a control there.
The Animage is gonna farm very fast from now on, because of Lance and Battle Fury.
So OG's win, one of the win conditions is that they need this Aegis on Storm Spirit. They need these charges to go up on this Bloodstone.
Oh, they're gone.
Not a whole lot of damage.
Disappointing.
but they rotate, rotation in the back, relocate on onto three heroes with a call down. Beastmaster bench are cleaned up. Ice Ice getting chased out, and Blink on in the front all alone. They don't have any damage, no survivability, and a bit of an overextension there for Wings. They don't have the anti-mage, and they're taking a 4v5 engagement, just outnumbered. Full ultimates expended from OG.
That was insane.
That was
awkward. Come on, man.
I think they fought like a DKS Husker, and they can like four man, you know, and the other guy is doing something, but it's not the case. So.
They just all died. Yeah. Only DK was Chrono. Gyrocopter relocated in. Boom, call down, everybody dead. Yeah, that's like Matumbaman Gyro level. Wait, like old Matumbaman. Not the current one. The old was a man. Now I'm a pussy.
I mean, that was kind of weird. The Chrono, like, I don't know, he just cornered the DK, but they all died, so
yeah.
Well done, I guess. Wings has to be careful, because it's just a clear 4v5 in front of the tower, and I guess they don't expect OG to respond, but OG is so good at defending the tower. You see, they went to the top lane too. They only lost the void there, and still lost the tower, but they're ready to do it. They don't want to give away, like, free shit. They don't give you free shit. They still want to, like, do something about it.
And like you mentioned, he just picked up his Bloodstone, so they wanted to get him some charges, and he got like three or something from
that's
that one
a dream.
Fight.
Like, that was a total dream. Like, perfect. He got a Bloodstone, and now he got like already his first Oblivion stuff. It was a very big push for the Storm Spirit to become monstrous in this game. This game is, like, at this point, still very even. Animage, he's still in the game, doing Animage things. DK is starting to become a bit weaker, because it's not the kind of games you want to have with DK. With DK you want to keep snowballing the games. Even if it's just a slow snowball, at least the game needs to progress consistently. Because DK is not a real late gamer. It's a Dragon Knight that has a very big cooldown, like downtime of like 1 minute to make him a ranged hero. And two supports of Wings Gaming have little to no purpose if they don't actually go for the five man.
I think OG won't push the tower.
Yeah, OG will be very, very confident now. They won a very big fight. They're very confident in taking more fights. Oh, Gyro actually just got his BKB. Like, yeah. So
next
quick.
Next item is Rapier, I'm sure.
Pretty sure, yeah.
Yeah, pretty sure it's Rapier.
That's a good move by OG. And this game will just like become like awkward, stagnating, because Wings is like, alright, animage, like. Shadow carry us, and OG is like doing the normal moves, like pressing the advantage that they clearly have. So as soon as the Roshan will happen, it should be happening like very soon, probably in the next like 2 minutes, people, both teams will like consciously be about the Roshan, like shit will go down.
Yeah, they're really put there. It's really like shadow carry us, and they just use the Hawk to give vision and give him all the information, and at least just maybe just follow him around with the supports while your other two heroes, the Beastmaster and the DK, just try to make space. But
yeah, we already see actually the two supports sitting behind Animage. They're thinking like maybe OG is like sitting top. They want to like kill the Animage, bait him. But I think OG has like the next level idea. I mean, like the more important vision, and that's the Roche area. They're already prepping up, and they got a DD.
They can't do it yet because Animage has pressure on top lane. He's gonna push the towers down. They need to react first before this Roche.
I mean, I think they can go Roche and Void can go top and Chrono the guys, because they have relocate. They can like make that kind of play.
Yeah. Smoke from OG. Yeah. Wisp and Gyro
OG
in the
is
mid showing.
Yeah.
So Wings is expecting a mid push.
Yeah, they're actually gonna go for the top play with relocate. Yeah. They just want this one single kill and go straight up Roche and like
yo.
Oh no.
Wow. That was pretty legit.
Like, you see OG's positioning on Wisp and Gyro is they are close to the Roche area because they want to relocate, get the kill. Like, if you get one kill, they can go straight up Roche, because it's like four heroes against five heroes. You just force like a good Roche on your side on the map. That was unfortunate. They could have had the kill. But now they put the ward there, so it was a good movement anyway, so they see their own woods. So the next time Wings goes there, might be just a repetitive movement of what we just saw. Just wondering if they could just go Roche. Would they do well? Animage is kind of strong now.
The Roche is really slow on OG.
Yeah.
They really want like five dead heroes before they go there.
Yeah, I can see it.
Can also be super scary, like one stun on that Storm route with the Manta Anti-Mage, and it can be pretty devastating if OG's not in a good position.
I actually see OG winning this game. There's gonna be a huge Roshan clash.
Are we going for it? Oh, no mana.
Oh, no mana. Yeah, there's gonna be a huge Roshan clash, and then they're gonna kill this Storm guy. He's gonna heal up his teammates. Then he's gonna respawn so fast and come back in there, steal the Roshan, steal the Aegis.
He got Sumail, 16 charges.
2015.
That's what
winning the international for his team.
He has 16 charges. That's 48 seconds of less respawn.
But he still needs Lincoln.
Yeah, he has so much items. Oh, Bloodstone Orchid.
Yeah, but it's not enough for him to survive the fight.
Cricket gets some sick relocates though.
I have full faith in that guy.
Yeah.
Great. Both of them. Two-time major champion. Dream Green.
Is that the thing now?
You guys are gonna be singing it too? At least I'm dreaming green right now.
That's fine.
Oh, two times Liquid got second place. Yeah.
No, I call it two-time major finalist.
I mean, that sounds good.
That sounds really good.
All right.
All right.
Miserable. Oh, they got him.
All right. Fly gets grabbed.
He might chrono back.
Oh, Fly actually lives.
Yeah.
Mirko afterwards.
Mirko is pretty big.
Yeah.
Oh, he gets the suicide off though.
Very good by Mirko. Doesn't give any mage a big kill.
Garo haven't used his BKB.
Any mage.
Looking pretty good for Wings right now.
Yeah, any mage. Yeah. Do any mage things.
Oh,
so fast.
He's dead.
Oh, he's got zip and lift.
He got the ball, I think.
Oh, he got zip.
Yeah.
Ice boss.
He's got
mana void him, dude.
Mana void him.
Mana void?
Yeah. I would mana void him.
Yeah,
you get
course.
More gold.
So much money.
Yeah.
Dude, you just want to KS, dude.
You get the staff points as well.
Yeah, maybe it's like next level. Like maybe Storm will come back. I want to keep my ulti.
Yeah, maybe.
Or respawn.
I think you save your mana void there, dude. Get the hell out of here.
What?
The
this is coming from a pro player. Come on, dude.
Oh, Jesus.
Oh, Jesus. Honestly, I would have mana voided.
You would have mana voided?
Yeah.
I guess I'm wrong, guys.
Yo, he's jumping on TK.
Oh shit, any mage, go back there!
You have the mana void!
Yeah, he has the mana void.
See, now he may as well have used it on the DK.
Any mage.
Oh, maybe not.
Where are
you? Look, he's coming!
Yeah, any mage, dude, show me the mana void! Just do it. Do
Stop
it.
Stop doing it.
I get the void.
Oh.
Maybe he will hear?
It's a very good kill. Like, stalls a game of void. I wonder if he should go. Yeah, he's
got Bashir too.
Yeah,
Bash. Bash. Bash.
Hello?
Hello?
Bash? No?
No, 4 hits.
Chase him again. Oh, crit.
What? Oh, no.
Bash.
No.
Bash.
Holy shit.
Come on.
6 hits.
Man. 6 hits? There we go. He was saving it.
Yeah.
That was very unfortunate.
Oh, yeah, but they are going to get Fly now too.
Yeah, be careful. Gyro's back now.
Oh, they can take this. Animage. Blink in.
Man up. If they had a one bash on Wiz, he might have just died.
Yeah.
See, he still didn't use mana void. He would have had it by now.
Fair enough. You guys know better.
All the stat points would have been recovered.
That was a very good jump by the DK on the tier 2 tower Radiant. I think the response of Moon was very good. Actually, like he got a chrono off, but the gyro was not in position to deal all the deeps.
They needed to burst on the Beastmaster.
Yeah.
Yeah. It just seemed like Wings was super prepared for that movement from
they were.
OG. They like put the sentry down and they expected everything. They had all five heroes in a proper positioning while OG was just a little bit lagged behind.
Yeah, and if you look at the net worth, it's like this is where you like start feeling like anxious like when this thing happened where Zenny mage just gets one more item on you or like two more items.
It's also like if you get a one kill on this animage, the tank game might just turn like that.
That's true.
But it's really hard because
someone
is going to have an Ultra Basher. And he's just like burst targets on his
It always differentiates like the masterclass animages and the just good animages are like the guys who just dictate the game.
And yeah, there's only like the Chronosphere, so it's not gonna get much easier. You really need to like a hex or something on your Storm, but once that's not gonna come for a long time, and then there's not really anyone who builds anything else to really have lockdown.
I mean, I like the animage that go big or go home. You just build a Ultra Basher and bash them. No BKBs or these pussy items.
I'm not a fan of BKB too. I think it's like too pussy in your words. But
in your words, I like that.
So it's true, though.
Throw the blame on
him. He's right. Like, you can go big on any mage. You can be a superstar. You are a superstar. Everyone, like, you know, can't use all these nice words. Everyone is, like, treating you nicely on the map. Like, you get all the farm and stuff. Wait, this is a classic Wings. They just go for Roche. Don't give a fuck. But now finally we see the Roche clash. We've been waiting for this for 10 minutes maybe.
Matu said what was going to happen before. Do you think that's still going to happen?
It's not going to happen.
It's not going to happen.
No. Oh, it's not happening.
Moon jumps out, but he does get the time dilation on AM. He doesn't want to use his Manta right now.
This is beautiful for Wings. Baited out the Chrono. Excellent.
Blowing everything on crit.
Naughty has to be careful now. Miracle comes in.
Miracle's godlike.
What?
Oh, they're turning on the animage.
Oh,
that's Sunder. Cool.
That's a value man of
this is according to plan.
Oh, Innocence boss. Swaps his teammate, gets the stun off.
Oh. You bought back?
I think animage also got the godlike streak of storm, so there's a lot of gold.
Yeah, he did.
Yeah.
I mean, the fight, like, obviously it was all about the Chrono, just got whiffed. There was pressure on the Moon Meander, to be fair, because he doesn't know like how low Roshan is. We see it, it's easy for
Dice?
Big plays.
The Roshan still?
Oh no,
I told you guys.
Ice Ice won't let that happen,
they,
dude.
They know,
no,
man.
They don't see him. They don't see
no,
him.
No, they know.
No, he knows.
Oh,
they
no.
They got him.
Yeah.
The lift.
Unfortunate things happened.
Uh-oh.
Very good patience by Wings. Stopped hitting the Roche. Just waiting for the right moment. How did they... Did he bash him first on the blink? Or did he just lift him right away?
I think he got the... I think he lifted him right away.
Yeah. And the Rubick Aurea was starting to run after him. He jumped to the right. I think he saw the zip to the other side. So they knew for sure the storm was there. At the same time, they know like every storm player wants to like make these big plays on Roche. It can work. It can't work. I think it was a good try. But him dying is very costly. Like he lost another bunch of Bloodstone charges.
I feel like he had to try that.
I think so too. Yeah. Because the game will just like just snowball out of hand very quickly. I saw OG winning for a moment in this game. Then
yeah,
things just fell apart.
Very quickly changed. He's got Mana Void up again too.
The Mana Void genius. He knows how to use it. Oh, he would get it off on the storm there.
He should be able to chase though. No, he actually got the full zip out. But that should be a Rax.
I mean, that's
nice.
I'd feel like not that bad of being OG. I mean, I would because I'm losing, but I got the Aegis of any mage, so it's like this Aegis any mage is you can just lose the game instantly. But they actually got it right away.
I mean, I feel like they're losing the game right now because of the Aegis.
I know, but I'm casting.
Still alive, dude.
I'm casting.
All right,
So
I don't think they can kill the anti mage again.
No, it's hard.
It's too hard.
Like, they are Chrono off. Time for big plays.
Yeah, I'm still impressed
Never
by the OG.
Oh, the sand image. I think it's not enough.
Storm is going in on the bench.
Yeah, the backline.
AM's line. Just gonna focus him though. Yep,
yeah.
Gets
yeah.
the Abyssal. Oh my. Yep.
That's
I
a
think
fuck
that's
mana void right there.
That's
yeah.
Yeah,
that's good,
yeah,
man.
Thanks, man.
No problem.
Thanks, dude.
I was still impressed by OG. They got much further than I thought in terms of finding the winning condition. Like they could have won the game. I thought at the start of the draft like there's no real way of OG winning because the game is too simple for Wings. It's a very simple idea. Everyone like knows Animage is a simple idea in Dota. Like if he has like a good time against their course, he clearly has against Storm and Gyro. Mm-hmm. If they don't have enough catch, they don't. They have a Wisp and Treant. They have one Chronosphere, and it's too much burden on the Void. And he had like secured free farm. Like everything just went his way for any mage to have this kind of game. And it's very hard.